This is Daniel De Lorenzo. Okay, I'm the Sales and Business Development Director for the FCAS program. Okay, for INDRA. It's called NGWS, Next Generation Weapon System. This is not about developing a new aircraft. It is more than that. It is a sixth generation fighter together with a set of remote carriers and manned vehicles interconnected by a combat cloud that will be the key enabler for something which is new, which is the system of system approach, the sum of several elements working together. The biggest defense European program currently in Europe. For first time, Spain has joined exactly at the same level as Germany and France to the program. From the Spanish industrial setup, INDRA holds the position of national coordinator. We are also leading certain elements of the program. The program is divided into different kind of activities called pillars. INDRA is leading either internationally or nationally four of the seven pillars. In Spain, we also have Airbus SAU, Airbus Spain, leading the participation in the fighter. It is expected to have the initial operational capability, the IOC, in 2040. For that to happen, we have now a period of around 10 years where we will have maturation of technologies and demonstrations up to roughly the end of the 2020s. And in the 2030s, we have the design and development and the production of the first units. So it's a program full of innovation, the transformation of the defense sector with all the digitalization of the products, okay, will happen thanks to this program.
Captain Eugene Alvey, I'm a tactical director with 5-7 Air Defense Battalion in the 10th Air and Missile Defense Command. We're here right now behind me. We have a Patriot launching station. To my right then, we also have a Striker, a 2nd Cavalry Regiment brought down with them. And then 144 Fires Brigade has brought an MLRS, multiple launch rocket system. This here kind of gives you a spread of land capability. We all came down from Germany, showing the strength of our partnership with Spain, specifically with Patriot. The Patriot weapon system operates as a lower tier air and missile defense system, which gives us a capability of countering unmanned aerial vehicles, cruise missiles, manned aircraft, and then ballistic missiles as well. And we're able to integrate across different weapon systems with our allies across Europe and NATO. That's why we brought this piece of equipment, particularly the launcher, down here with us to display that capability. 5-7 is the Patriot battalion in Europe. There's only one. And then we go across Europe for a number of exercises.
My name is Joxan Bojorquez. I am the business development director in Escribano Mechanical and Engineering. So what we have here is the Escribano remote weapon station. This one is Guardian L-Hit. Guardian L-Hit is the weapon system for 30 by 113 weapons. We have already integrated the M230LF, and what we are showing here today is our latest integration with Nexter weapon, 30 by 113. There is for sure a request of this caliber in the market at the moment, and this is what we are proposing as the European solution for this request. It is a heavier turret. Nevertheless, it is around 260 kilograms, and it can be mounted on lighter vehicles. All of the Escribano products, all of the Guardian family and the Sentinel family, are produced. Around 90% of the systems are produced by us. We are very open to collaborate with companies outside of Spain.
My name is Sergio De Frutos. I'm the general manager of Ferri Systems. Now we are here trying to present this product that is a unmanned surface vehicle for the sea. And this is one vehicle that can be remote operated from any part of the world, can be working with a Escribano gun that is on the bow of the boat. We can reach any part of the world because this possibility to be controlled by satellite signal is unmanned, totally unmanned. And there is some automatic function that it can be done, like a survey function, in order to check the borders of the countries, and is specially dedicated for this. We have got Oteos camera from Escribano Company, able to reach long distance at night. The vehicle is not our product. The product is really a remote control system, a unmanned system in any vehicle that you can have. You can put it in any other vessel. It's not needed. This can be the customer vessel.
My name is Lieutenant Sanz. I am a Spanish Army pilot, and this is the Spanish target helicopter. It's an attack helicopter. In this helicopter, we can come with a 30 millimeter gun We can also have air-to-air missiles, Mistral missile, which has 5 kilometers of attack radius. And then we have the air-to-ground missile, spike missile, long range. Air-to-air missile is for protection and attack on any other aircraft. And air-to-ground missile is for bunkers, maybe buildings, and of course, armored vehicles. On the right wing, we can have external fuel tank in case our mission is long way from home. And then we can also have 70 millimeter rockets. The configuration of the helicopter can vary depending on our mission and our purpose. The helmet is an important part of the aircraft. This is because it's integrated with the whole aircraft. The helmet has mounted night vision, so it can display on the front, and also all the flight data is displayed on the front. One interesting thing about the helmet is that all the weapon system is associated with the helmet. If I wanted to fire any type of weapon that the aircraft is carrying, I could do it with my helmet. I would just look at the target and fire away.
I'm Dennis Slingerland. I'm CTO at Ventor Innovations, startup company developing composite structures and drones. This is our V-Raptor drone in the shape of a bird. It has two main applications. The first one is bird deterrence. You can think of airports, crop fields, fishing factories, or windmill farms. And the other one, that's the model we're presenting right now, is the observance model. It has a gimbal camera at the bottom of the aircraft, vibrator system camera, and an infrared camera as well. It has a flight time of about 2 hours, completely autonomous. It can be launched by hand, by catapult. You just push a button, it flies away, it flies a pre-designated pattern and lands where you want it to. We've used this trade fair to present it to the public. The responses up to now have been very, very well received. So
my name is Miguel Bezares, I'm the business development manager of COHEMO, a Spanish company within the defense sector. We are the company who is in charge of the maintenance of all the vehicles of the Leopard family, and currently we are presenting here solution because we normally propose to our army to implement some upgrades and to try to improve the fleet. In this case, we have a proposal that within the same birds or chassis and in less than 5 hours or less than 1 hour in some cases, we can have a very versatile vehicle. From the armor engineering vehicle to the armor recovery vehicle till the meme reaching vehicle. It's quite good also for us to have these strong partners because allow us to cover all the scope that we want to offer to the army. It's really pleasant to be able to meet again in a physical or normal Congress again, and I think that's the feeling in the Congress, that people really needed to go again to normality.
My name is Carlos Alvarez. I am the COO of UMILES Group, a Spanish company that produces unmanned ARV vehicles. And this is our product called SATURNO, an unmanned vehicle, 100% made in Spain, made in our factory in Madrid for rescue purposes or surveillance too. As you can see in the picture, it's a thermic camera. We can change it. There are so many options. It can also take life vest to rescue on the beach, for example. It's another purpose of this drone. Real test is about 30 minutes, real 30 minutes. It supports two batteries, independent batteries. You can fly it with the two or the one independent. You can't fly really out of the sea according to the European laws, but we test it at 5 kilometers.
I'm Gabriele Colombo. I'm the CEO of Leonardo España in Valencia. This is what we call a system for escalation of force. This is a preview of our system here in Spain with non-lethal approach. Non-lethal means that at a certain distance beyond 1 kilometer, you can inform people with the voice. You can reach very directly with local language in case with registered messages as well to advise people. Then you have a laser dazzler that helps to understand there is a critical situation. There is also a light and then a tracking, and when you are going to arrive close to the systems, the sound is so high that is quite becoming lethal for the ear. At the end, discriminating the people that are coming, if they are really close, you have also the gun in a situation of camp in order to protect the FOB. The soldier, it's also useful on 4x4. It's also useful for police, even the version without the cannon, because with the sound you can also use for urban situation. Here you can see hit with a 12.7, 762, but you can also have a missile. You can have two guns instead of the lethal. You can use the lethal in a second situation. So the modularity is one of the key points of this system.